Good morning students, welcome to English class. In today's class we are going to learn about a poem, The Lost Dances of Cranes. What do you see in the picture? We could see two birds in the picture, isn't it? So we might have come across a many birds. Have you seen birds dancing? Yes, we always refer to the dancing of a peacock, is it? Also, we might have seen birds walking in the fields and flying over the fields. Have you seen that? Yes, we refer it as cranes, isn't it? And now name the object or the machine which is used to lift heavy objects. So normally we used to call it as JCBs. And the other name for that particular machine is called crane, isn't it? So in this poem also, there is a pun on the word crane. And let us see the similarity in their dance. Shall we move on to the poem? The Last Dances of Cranes was written by Juliet Wilson. So Juliet Wilson was born in Manchester and studied in Edinburgh, where she still lives. She writes environmental poetry and edits the blog magazine Bowls of Silk. She has had over 50 poems published in UK poetry journals. This poem is a good example of her concern and anguish over the destruction of the environment. So let us read the poem, The Lost Dances of Cranes by Juliet Wilson. Your fields are empty now, only your ghosts dance, while cranes of another kind dance cities into being. All that remain of you are a fading crackle of your energy and some grainy video footage that people in the new cities will watch to marvel at the wonders of the world once held. So once again I am reading. Your fields are empty now, only your ghosts dance, while cranes of another kind dance cities into being. All that remain of you are a fading crackle of your energy and some grainy video footage that people in the new cities will watch to marvel at the wonders of the world once held. So the theme of the poem, here the poet deals with the destruction of the environment. So in this poem, the poet laments. Laments mean feeling sad at the loss of cranes which she saw dancing in the fields. But she grieved at the sight of another type of cranes used for building cities, which is the machine cranes. So the poet is lamenting at this human activity. That is, we people now are destroying the agricultural lands and we are constructing huge buildings and apartments, isn't it? So for this construction purposes, we are using huge machines and they're called cranes for lifting heavy objects. And the poet is lamenting or feeling sad at this human activity that is destroying the environment. So in this poem, the poet addresses the cranes, the bird cranes, and says that their fields are now empty. The dances of the cranes have become a memory. So we could see the dancing of cranes only in the earlier days and not now. In places of these birds, another kind of cranes, that is the machines, are seen. The cranes are tall machines used for moving heavy objects like building materials. So the to and fro movement of the machines in the other kind of dance that the poet has referred to. So the poet says that nowadays we could not see the dancing of cranes, bird cranes in the field. Instead, we could see only the movement of the machine cranes in the fields. The birds are fading quickly. Fading means disappearing slowly, and they are present only in our memories and video footage. So the speaker seems to indicate that the near extinction of cranes is due to man's desire to build structures on the very home of the cranes, namely the wetlands where the cranes could survive. She feels that all that remains of the beautiful crane is only in the form of video footage or nature documentaries. So it is an irony that the ones, that means the we people, who are destroying the fields to construct buildings are watching nature videos and enjoying the nature in this way. The message that we get through this poem is to save our environment and protect the endangered species so that they don't become just memories. So rather than just watching the videos about nature, people should do something to protect nature. So people, as on today, people do not seem to realize that they are poor substitutes for the wonders of the world once held. But we are enjoying the videos, the nature videos, but we are not ready to save our nature. So the word meanings: fading, to disappear slowly; crackle, to make a series of sharp, short sounds; grainy, unclear; marvel, get surprise or admiration. So who is being addressed in the poem? The bird crane is being addressed in the poem. Which are the two dancers mentioned in the poem? The two dancers are the dance of the birds that could once be seen in the fields, and the other kind of dance is the dance of the urban machines that are used in constructing cities. The meaning of will watch to marvel. So it means to be filled with wonder and admiration at something surprising or extraordinary. Now, what is the left of the crane which used to dance in the fields? So it is the fading crackle. Crackle means the sound. The fading crackle of energy and some grainy video footage. What is the irony in the lost dances of cranes? It is the dance of the bird crane for creation with the dance of the mechanical cranes for destruction. So people responsible for the destruction of their environment mourns its loss without doing anything to restore it. So people feel for the loss of the nature, but they do not do anything to restore the nature. So homework, learn the poem and write the word meanings and answers for the comprehension in your fair note. Thank you, students.